start this month's Drones News Express with some positive news on how the drone industry is contributing to fight against COVID-19. Hi everyone, my name is Sasha and you're watching Drone Helpline. In a significant step, the Ministry of Civil Aviation has issued a conditional exemption from UAS Rule 2021 to the Telangana government. The exemption allows experimentation of BVLO's drone flights for COVID-19 vaccine delivery. So to do so, Telangana government collaborates with startups like Sagar Defense, Marut Drones, Serobotics, Avianco, to name a few. Additionally, Indian Council of Medical Research has also received similar permissions in collaboration with IIT Kanpur. The Ministry of Home Affairs has become a nodal authority after receiving a conditional exemption from UAS Rules 2021 by MOCA. Now onwards, MHA will be granting necessary permission for all drones used by agencies, departments, entities under its jurisdiction. Facilitating the growth of commercial drone operations in the country, 166 green zones have been approved by MOCA. Adding to the earlier approved 66 green zones, now we have a total of 232 green zones. NPNT drones in these green zones can get automatic approval from the Digital Sky platform. Good news for the private sector players. MOCA has given a conditional exemption for conducting drone-based aerial surveys in 23 locations of Tata Steel Limited for raw materials management and mapping of mining areas. SBI General Insurance to use drones for fast claim settlements in cyclone-hit states of Orissa, West Bengal and Jharkhand. Another body receiving a conditional exemption from UAS Rule 2021 is Indian Oil Corporation Limited to carry out drone-based inspection of equipment and stacks at its Panipat refinery. DGCA has recently issued a public notice for all drones manufacturers who have received provisional NPNT compliance acceptance for their drone model listed in Digital Sky. It has advised those manufacturers to get their drone models certified by QCI on or before 31st August 2021. IIT Hyderabad becomes the first R&D entity to get registered under UAS Rules 2021 by DGCA. DGCA has accorded the first approval for an RPTO to the Center for Aerospace Research MIT under Anna University Chennai for conducting remote pilot training. Odisha Mining Corporation Limited has been accorded exemption from UAS Rules 2021 to use drones for conducting aerial surveys of mines. They will be deploying drones being developed by IG Drones at Sasubahu Mali Bauxite Mine. JUGAPRO India Private Limited and HUBBLEFLY Technologies Private Limited have become the first private entities to get R&D authorization as per UAS Rule 2021. Pipeline Infrastructures Limited has received a conditional exemption from MOCA for conducting aerial monitoring of natural gas pipelines. They will be engaging OMNIPRESENT robot technologies for conducting aerial monitoring between Nalgonda and Rangareddy districts of Telangana. Japanese drone developer ACSL will establish a joint venture in India with local startup AEROARC to manufacture and sell drones for industrial use. For developing a web-based solar rooftop tool, Madhya Pradesh's Madhya Kshetra Vidyut Vitaran Company has received conditional exemption. They will be engaging drones from EDALL systems for data acquisition and aerial survey of Bhopal, Gwalior, Indore and Jabalpur cities. Now looking at some news from Indian Defence. Indian Army will be soon getting 4 HERON TP drones on lease from Israel, which will be deployed along the line of actual control with China for long surveillance missions. BSF has foiled Pakistan's attempt to airdrop arms and ammunition by 2 drones along the international border in Jammu region during early morning hours. NTPC has received a conditional exemption from UAS Rule 2021 for conducting aerial surveys at the Kirandari coal mining project in Jharkhand. Opening up opportunities for the power line inspection industry, MOCA has given conditional exemption to Power Grid Corporation. Power Grid Corporation will carry out aerial inspection of power transmission lines for the Agra-Aligarh power line. Central Mine Planning and Design Institute Limited has received conditional exemption for aerial survey in mining areas using drones at open cast projects of National Coal Limited. Due to the ongoing pandemic, mega drone light show couldn't happen even after granting permission to Kumbh Mela authorities and Showcraft Productions Noida. But DGCA and MOCA have opened up a new scope for drone industry, which will surely be explored in the coming future. We would like to appreciate Smit Shah from Drone Federation of India and Unbound Future Foundations for their joint effort in raising funds and donating oxygen concentrators to the Station Medical Center at Air Force Station Palan. With this positive note, we come to the end of this month's Drones News Express. To get more updates, follow our Drone Helpline Facebook and LinkedIn page. Link is provided in our description box below. You can also provide us with your views, ideas and feedback. Thank you for watching. Do like our video. Do not forget to share and subscribe to our Drone Helpline YouTube channel.